This is Film Masters, and on this episode, we're making something from Doctor Strange. It's gonna look like this.
I've spent so many years peering through time.
Looking for you.
Now, down below in the comment section is a download element that you can download and use to your heart's content. I'm going to show you how to make that in another tutorial. However, we're going to get straight into this one and show you how it's done.
Now, at the very beginning of this tutorial, you've seen some demonstrations of some of the stuff that you can actually do with this pre-animated effect. Now, the animated effect obviously is in the download section. And later on, I'm going to be showing you, not in this tutorial, but in an upcoming tutorial, how to actually make these yourself. Now, making them is very simple. It's very similar to making HUDs, similar to the Iron Man HUD. But I'll still do the tutorial and show you how to make it from scratch. So let's import it. Let's bring that file straight onto our project line. So next thing I'm going to do is go straight down to the screen mode and change that to screen. And once we've done that, it's just a matter of lining it up against our video footage. So I'm going to make this effect so it's underneath my hand. So what I'm going to do is, first of all, make it a 3D layer. And I'm going to adjust it and move it into position. Once I've got it into position, I'm going to obviously scale it. Now, one thing I'd urge you to do is go out there and do your own footage. Go do a trial test, or unless you want to do your own Doctor Strange trailer, and go out there and just go video something so that you can use this yourself. So I'm just moving this effect into position. Now, it's already pre-animated, as you're aware. So I'm just going to go and hide the layer now so that we can just work on the video footage. So I'm going to select that and I'm going to track the motion. So let's go down and track the motion of the clip. And I'm just going to move our tracking marker to a position on the hand, because we want the effect to move with the hand. So I'm just looking for a spot on my hand. So I'm going to use a freckle that's there. Once I've found my track marker, I'm going to play forward. Now, while it's doing that, there is another option when you don't have a freckle on the back of your hand, for example. You can get a marker and just put a small mark on the back of your hand. And use that as a tracker. And then what will happen is it's just a matter of moving that marker off your hand. Now, that's something we'll probably cover in another tutorial later on when we start to get into other effects where we start to use tracking. But for this effect, I'm not putting a marker on the back of my hand. So again, what we're doing is we're tracking the hand so that we can place our Doctor Strange effect under the hand, but also when the hand's moving, even the slightest move, it's going to be tracking with that. So that's the reason why we're doing it. Okay, so we've finished doing that. So we're going to hit edit target. And in the layer, I'm going to make sure that I select the Doctor Strange effect and select OK. And then I'm going to select apply and make sure apply dimensions are X and Y and select OK. And as you can see, once we've done that, all our tracker markers are down there. I'm just going to turn the effect back on so we can see it. And I'm just going to hide the track motion data. So when I originally did the tracking of the data, as you can see, my hand was moving and the effect doesn't. Now, the reason for that is because I want it to fade in. So as soon as it no longer tracks to the hand, I'm just going to come in here and trim the effect, which is what I've just done there on the timeline. So we're going to animate the transparency now. So let's press T on the keyboard and set a keyframe. And I'm going to move it, first of all, just drop it down to zero. And I'm going to move it around two frames forward. Now, I do that by using the page down button on my keyboard. And obviously, page up goes backwards on the timeline. And I'm going to move two frames forward and increase the transparency. And then I'm going to decrease it by half, and then I'm going to move a few frames forward and then bring it back up to 100%. Now, the reason I'm doing that is because I want the effect to transition in So a little bit of a pulse as it sort of starts up. Something that you see in the trailer itself, in the teaser. So here we go. So what happens is we've got that little flicker as it almost like a light turning on, an old style light. So I've just done that. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure that the element that we've got in there is in the right position. So I'm going to select A on my keyboard so I can move the anchor point. And by moving the anchor point around, it allows me to reposition the effect without affecting the tracking that we've done on the hand. So I'm able to reposition it using the anchor point. So once I'm happy with that, I'm just going to hide it on the timeline. So now let's go up to effect, blur and sharpen. And I'm going to go down to directional blur. And directional blur will give us that real-time movement blur effect. So I'm going to change the blur amount to 15. And after we've done that, we're going to go up to effect. And we're going to go to color correction now. And we're going to go down to curves. So curves will allow us to get the color that we're after. So I'm just going to go and select green. And I'm going to increase that, as you can see. And I'm going to go down to blue now, and I'm going to decrease that till I get the desired color that I'm after. Now, the next step is I'm going to go down to the effect, and I'm going to duplicate that layer. So now we've got two of those Doctor Strange video effects there. I'm just going to name this effect top. And I'm going to go down to the bottom, the original one, and I'm going to call this one blur. Now, I did that by hitting enter on my keyboard, and it allows me to change the name of the layer. So I'm going to go up to blur and sharpen and Gaussian blur. I'm going to change the Gaussian blur amount to 300. Now that I've done that, I'm going to go and select the pick whip on the blur layer and attach that to the top layer. So therefore, anytime I move the top layer around, it will move around with the other element. So that blur will stick to it. So I'm going to hide the layer now. So just hide it so we can't see it anymore. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to duplicate the hand layer and bring that up to the very top. And now I've called that layer hand. And now I double click on it. So it opens up in the composition window. And I'm going to go up to the roto brush now. So I'll select the roto brush. And I'm going to start drawing where I want the mask to be. So I'm just roughly going around my hand, and once I've done that and release the mouse button, it automatically puts a mask around my hand. Now I'm going to use the Alt key on my keyboard so that I can fine tune that roto mask. I'm just going to go around and just draw in the parts in between my fingers so that the roto brush tool can have a look at where my hand is for when it's doing the mask. So over in the effects window, you can see all the parameters that we can make adjustments to, which we'll do a little bit later on to fine tune the mask. So I've just cut the layer down so it's in line with the effects layers. And I'm just adjusting now, as you can see, where I want the roto brush to keep on working to. So it's just that element that's highlighted on the timeline up the top. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to press the space bar on the keyboard, and what that's going to do is allow it to track forward with the roto brush. Now, anytime that the actual roto brush or the mask around my hand moves away from where I want it to be, I'll stop that actual render of the video by selecting the space bar, and I'll zoom in, for example, and I'll make those finer adjustments, as you can see. So what I'm doing is I'm keeping an eye on where the mask is, and going frame by either using the page down or the page up buttons, or pressing the space bar and tracking forward. So every time I track forward and I see the mask move again, I'll stop the video, and then I'll either press the Alt button to cut away some of the mask, or I'll just simply allow it to go in there and draw in around the fingers. Now, once I've done that and I want to stop the roto brush from doing it, I just simply go up and go back to the composition window. And what we'll see then is what we've done. So you can see the hand now is above the element. It does look a little bit rough around the hand though. So we're going to make some finer adjustments to the roto brush in the effects window. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go up to the effects window and I'm going to change smooth, which currently is defaulted out at 2.0. I'm going to change that to 10. So let's change that to 10 first of all and see what that looks like. And that should help to smooth out the pixels around the fingers, as you can see there. So it doesn't look as jagged. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go up to feather and change it from 20 to 30. And that's just going to give it a bit more of a feather around the fingers. So it looks like light is starting to come through. And then I'm going to change the choke to 15. So that will give us a nice look. Now, the next thing I want to do is I want to apply effects so that it has a bit of like a light wrap. And funny enough, that's what one of the presets are called. It's called light wrap. And what it does is it makes it look as if there is light coming around the fingers. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go up to the presets window and I'm just going to simply write in there light wrap. So once you've found light wrap in the presets window, I'm just going to grab that preset and I'm going to put it onto my hand layer, which is the layer that we did the rotoscoping on. And once I've done that, I'm going to go up straight up to the effects window and we're going to make some adjustments so that we can bring that light up. So let's go up to the background layer and select the effect. So that's going to bring some of that light spill, as you can see, around the fingers. I'm then going to change the composition mode from add to screen and change width to 20 and brightness. I will just leave that as it is, but change blend with original to 10. Now I might just make some finer adjustments and you'll find that you'll need to do the same thing because you'll probably be using a different clip. So I'm using the background blur and just playing around with that and the width, just so I can wrap the light a little bit more around my fingers until I'm happy with the way the effect looks. So this way it gives a little bit of a light wrap around the fingers. Now the next thing we're going to do is we're going to go through and I'm just going to show you that obviously we've selected green. Now we can change the color. It doesn't have to be green because in the teaser, the color is also a magenta. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to show you how to do that quick change. And it's just a matter of selecting the element, both elements that we've used and making some changes to the curves in the effects layer. So this is what the effect now looks like. Now that we've done a bit of a preview and you can see that the light's wrapping around the fingers nicely around the forearm as well. Now I'm just going to select the layer, probably just going to change it, give it a little bit more depth. So I'm just going to tilt it till I'm happy with the perspective it's in. And I'll do the same with the blur as well so that it sits right. Now with the curves, obviously, like I was saying before, we've currently got it set as is. You know, you just go to reset if you'd like, or you can just go through red, for example, and bump that up and push the greens down. And then same with the blues, we'll just move them further down. And that gives it that reddish magenta look. And I'm just going to do the same with the blur layer, because at the moment it's got the green from the previous one. It's going to adjust it. So this is another way, obviously, that with the effects, you can change the color of it. Now there's other colors, obviously you can change it to purple, whatever color you want, depending on the movie. We've only seen the two colors so far. So once you've done all that, your effect should look like this.
Now, if you want to become a Film Master sub, it's pretty simple. You have to do is subscribe to the channel, like us on Facebook and or on Twitter. And until next time, don't just film it, master it.